Greetings and welcome to the Jacksonville Buzz. I am your host, Adrienne Houghton. Exciting guest in the studio today. It is Will Drakus from Hon Sushi Catering, and we're going to find out all about him and his catering company. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning.
So before we get on to your catering company, Hon Sushi, let's talk a little bit about Will.
Okay, sure. I guess I've been doing sushi since 2002.
Wow.
I worked for a restaurant for 12 years. Then I decided I was going to open my own restaurant. Didn't like that. Went to Charlotte, worked at a place called Baku, trained a lot there, learned more about the traditional arts. Then I started working with the Jaguars, then the Atlanta Braves, then COVID happened. Now I have my own business. So
there we go. I mean, in a nutshell, it's been condensed
into
30 seconds. Because sushi, I mean, it's an unusual
it's not something
most people would go for. What made you want to go for Japanese?
I've always been into the Asian culture, and I guess I ended up working in a Japanese steakhouse, like I was saying. And
okay.
From there, I saw sushi, and I like the challenge, I guess. Yeah. That's really what it boils down to. It's a big challenge when you do sushi.
Did you learn to toss all the knives and things like that?
A little bit. I wasn't too much of a fan of that.
No.
But with sushi, I really enjoyed it. It's
yeah.
relaxing. You know, it's a lot of detail work. It's detail oriented. It's just fun for me.
So you started your own company, Hon Sushi. And mm-hmm. what does that mean?
It means number one, sushi catering. So Hon's like, it can mean several different things in Japanese, but the way I have it set up is number one.
And what does your catering company offer?
Well, we offer a wide variety of different sushi. Basically, we customize every menu to each individual client. Of course, if they have dietary needs, we offer that as well. But a lot of the focus on my company is providing a service for people to have, where we literally just come to their house and set up, do everything in front of them. And I guess it's kind of a private chef kind of situation. But we also do big contracts like the Jaguars, and I just got back from East Lake. So, you know, just a lot of different things we do. So,
talking about big contracts, I believe somebody went to the Olympics in Japan.
I did. I was there for 28 days and did sushi every single day, about 1,000 plus boxes a day. It was pretty intense.
And you were working for the NBC team, is that correct?
Correct, yeah. And the IBC.
And 1,000 boxes a day. I mean, how many were you on a team?
Just two of us, basically. And we had one temp employee. They would, you know, it was just kind of a tough situation, but yeah.
Goodness me. And did you do everything from the ordering of all the food to the preparation?
Oh, yeah.
And so how long were you actually there, and how many days did you cook for?
28 days and 28 days.
Oh,
every
was that
single
it?
Day.
So you arrived and it was like, right, we've got to order this food in. We've got to get this.
I ordered it months before.
Oh.
I set up, you know, spreadsheets and all that, and ordered all my equipment and had it sit over there. I worked with their executive chef, and we lined everything up.
What an incredible experience. If you could take one thing away from there as perhaps enhancing your cuisine, what would it be?
Well, we had, you know, the high quality fish, and it was just the experience of being able to work with different Japanese products, you know, different things that I haven't even got to experiment with yet here.
Yeah.
So I'm sure there's going to be a lot of fun I get to have with some of the new ingredients I worked with.
Are you able to find them here?
Oh, yeah.
That's half of them.
I actually have access to their fish market over there now through one of their wholesalers. So
how wonderful.
Yeah, I worked on that while I was there. So
that was a huge plus.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. So you do private catering. You do corporate events.
Yes.
And do you only bring all the stuff to the venue and then cook it there?
We're working on getting the to-go side of things set up, but mostly we don't do drop-offs mostly. We just do live catering. Probably within the next, I would say by January, we'll have it all set up for drop-offs.
And is it something where if somebody said, oh, can you come along? I'd like some sushi for a party. That people can watch you do it?
Yeah, they watch us.
Oh, they do?
The entire time. We set up the full sushi bar.
How fantastic. And what's your favorite sushi?
My favorite?
Yes.
Is nigiri. Probably toro and marai.
Those okay, now you're going to have
snapper.
To, you're going to have to, I was going to say,
Japanese
you're going to have to explain
snappers,
that.
Madai, and then toro is like the belly side of the tuna. Those two are probably my favorite.
Yes. Now there's a difference between sushi and sashimi, is that mm-hmm. right? And
well, so
the difference
sushi
is?
Means wrapped in rice, so it's like a roll. And
okay.
then nigiri is the fish over rice, and then sashimi is sliced fish by itself.
Oh, that's what I like.
You like the sashimi?
Yes.
Me too. It's very delicious.
It's delicious. I mean, and the flavor comes straight through and everyone says, ew, how can you do that? It's raw. And it's like, but it's so fresh and clean.
For the quality of the product, it depends like where you're going, obviously. Yeah. But I don't deal with anything but the best quality. So.
And I mean, obviously you said that Asian is your sort of interesting.
Well, I love the food.
Cuisine. Is there another cuisine that you also like?
Probably Korean and Vietnamese. Those are my favorites.
Okay.
Outside of sushi.
Yes. And if somebody comes to you and says, I would like you to do all things Asian for me, can you do that?
We can, of course, but we try not to push too far out of the boundary for now. We'll
just
expand
keep it simple.
A little further. I can do bao buns. We've done hibachi a few times. While I was in East Lake, we did a raw bar, which was insane.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
It was beautiful and amazing. I mean, all that stuff is on my Instagram. So it's kind of like you can go look at it and see what we
offer. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. And do you have three tools that you can't live without?
Definitely. My fish tweezers to pull all the bones out.
Whoa.
My sharpening stone and my knives.
And that's that.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. So if people want to get hold of you, how do they find Hon Sushi?
You can go to honsushicatering.com.
As simple as that.
You just go on there and you can write me an email or call me, one of the two.
And how far out do people need to book?
I would say a month to 2 weeks right now, especially.
Okay.
And we're very busy, so.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for coming in. It's
thank
an absolute
you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Definitely.
And I look forward to tasting some of your sushi in the future.
We'll have to work that out, definitely.
Absolutely.
We'll set something up.
So if you'd like to know any more information, don't forget, it's the Hon Sushi Catering Company. And you can also find more information on iwantabuzz.com.